Well, nothing more we can say about that, but I know you have a plenty to say.
That's real good, Polly. That's almost worthy of me, brother. Almost worthy of me and the real Midnight Express. You know, Jimmy Crockett, Tommy Edwards, all the people at TBS, everybody that has anything to do with this program staying on the air, have already told me, don't say what you want to say, Jim Cornette, or we'll never stick you in front of a camera again. So this is the censored version. As soon as that happened, my mama found out that I got hurt. She called me up. She said, Jimmy, come on home. Don't worry about it. I'll have the lawyers take care of everything. You get out of professional wrestling. It's too dangerous. It's all over with. And I said, Mama, you're going to have to get over it, darling, because it's about damn time I did something on my own. Paulie Dangerously, I'm going to tell you something right now, brother. It takes more than a couple of geeks. Yeah, that's right, geeks. I like that word, so I'm going to use it. It takes more than a couple of geeks wearing funny-looking clown outfits with original Midnight Express on the back, copying our moves and taking our name to be the Midnight Express. Dennis Condrey, you say you carried Bob Eaton around. Well, at first it was an equal partnership, Dennis, but toward the end, Bob Eaton was carrying your big fat butt around. That's what actually happened. Bob Eaton and Dennis Condrey were never the U.S. Tag Team Champions for 15 months. Bob Eaton and Stan Lane were. Bob Eaton and Dennis Condrey were never the Tag Team of the Year. Bob Eaton and Stan Lane were. Bob Eaton and Dennis Condrey were the World Tag Team Champions, but so were Bob Eaton and Stan Lane, and they beat a better team to win them and beat better teams while they had them. So as far as I'm concerned and everybody in this country, Bob Eaton and Stan Lane are the Midnight Express. Now let me just come up here, guys, and let me just hold this up. Hold on a second. Hold on a second. I'm talking to Paulie Dangerously right now. Paulie, I have spent 5 years of my life. I have devoted 5 years of my life to trying to help make the Midnight Express the greatest tag team in professional wrestling. And during those 5 years, I have been beat up. I've been busted open. I have been stripped naked and knocked off a three-story scaffold. And I've deserved half of it, but I've took all of it. I'm still here, and I'll be damned if I'm gonna let a little jerk like you come in here and take my job. Paulie Dangerously, what you are is a cross between Michael Keaton and Jim Belushi. You're a punk with a suit two sizes too big and a Jim Cornette joke book slapped in your back pocket. Well, I tell you what we're going to do. You want to fight for the name? We'll fight for the name. And I'm going to keep this jacket. And when that fight's over with and everybody knows we're the real Midnight Express, then we're going to tear this thing in three pieces. And Bobby's going to take a sleeve and Stan's going to take a sleeve and stick it down Dennis Condrey and Randy Rose's throats. And I'm going to ball the rest of it up, Paulie. And I don't know which orifice on your body's the biggest. I think it's your mouth, but I may have to stretch one. And I'm going to ram this thing straight up to the elbow, up that very self-same hole.
We'll be back after this timeout.